Damn, that thing is big, dude.
Oh, I should have dumped it already.
Holy shit!
Every time they came in, they missed.
God damn it.
God damn it, not on the RVs!
That was a good drop.
Yeah. Pete and I are going to jump in the antique Luscombe today and take a fly over the Bennett Street fire and give you an idea of what it looks like from the air and show you how close it came to town and how close of a situation it was for our community. Then we'll go down on the ground and take a look at what's happening on the ground there and show you how the effective use of air tankers and ground firefighters quickly kept that fire small and quickly got it put out. Then we'll do a separate video and look at some of the neat Nevada County narrow gauge history that has been recently unearthed by this fire. Stay tuned.
That's sure bumpy. Ready for takeoff.
Check the rudder, Pete.
Give it a flip. Yeah, move it. And the rudder?
Tail.
Is it good? Thumbs up. Give me a thumbs up.
Okay.
You ready?
The other day, CDF, or correction, Cal Fire, says they've been called out 9 times to this location just this year. There's any number of ignition sources. I have no idea what's or where exactly this fire started from, but here's one example right here. A campfire area right along the edge of the burned area. Another interesting thing to point, oh, and there's right over here is another encampment just outside of the burn area. Some folks are staying there. Another interesting thing is this is right along the Nevada County narrow gauge right away. That's the old rail bed right up there. This place has been a site for homeless camping for years and years back to the narrow gauge railroad days. Another interesting thing is this fire has recently burned up and unearthed a lot of the junk that has been thrown out over the years, including Nevada County Narrow Gauge Railroad junk that was dumped over the side of the roadbed here and left right in this area. Lots of old trash right in here. Historic trash, too. Somebody else's firewood supply right here up on the roadbed. This is on top of the roadbed of the old Nevada County Narrow Gauge Railroad. This way heads up towards Bennett Street Agate Lumber Sales. And this way heads back towards town. And back in here is a large, rather popular homeless encampment back this way. It's also conveniently located to the new Hills Flat Lumber on the other side of this hill where folks can get lumber for their shelters. And here's some of the unfortunate trash that's left behind. It's very trashed out back in here. There's a shopping cart to get your supplies in and out of town. Now this is interesting. This is the effect of retardant from the air tankers, the red retardant right on top of the blackberries. It gives them a nice pink color. You can even see it down here on the trail. Pretty extensive trail system back here. There's the old, I lost track of the railroad bed from here, but there's a trail that way, and that way. We're back on the main railroad bed here. The narrow gauge went through this cut in here, and you can see the folks have even developed a staircase system to access the different trails back in here. And there's some more encampments right back in there, and right up in there in the hot, dry manzanita. This is all part of the blackened area walking on the old roadbed of the Narrow Gauge Railroad right here, heading towards, heading away from town towards Bennett Street, Agate Sales. I don't know what they're indicating there. Looky here. That's a Narrow Gauge Railroad tie plate right there, right off the main line. Additional homeless camps all up and down the line here. It's evidenced by the garbage and stuff left behind. I don't know what the solution is to homelessness. It's a huge story, a long story, but there's some great programs right here in Nevada County, including facilities like Hospitality House, Utah's Place, but they have some basic strings attached. You can't be using and you can't be drinking to come in and use the facilities. But we do have programs available. This fire was a very close call for our community. Of course, our Gold Rush history is ripe with fire history, and we don't need to be repeating that history. This was very close to town. Let's talk a little bit about the aerial attack on this fire. Very interesting case study on the use of air tankers on this fire. Keeping it small, getting it stopped in time. Before we talk about application of aerial assets on a forest fire, let's get some terminology right. Let's imagine that this is your forest fire, your Bennett Street fire. This would be Bennett Street down here. Winds are coming up out of the south this direction. This would be the approximate area where the fire started, or the heel of the fire. Here's where the fire is burning up to. This is called the head of the fire. This side is called the left flank. And this side is called the right flank, as oriented, looking at the fire this way. And the fire is burning that way. Fortunately, we got two S2 air tankers located right there at Loma Rica Airport, just a few miles away. And on duty that day was Tanker 88 and 89. In Tanker 88 was Colin Rogers, pilot of 88. And in Tanker 89, relief pilot, old friend Jimmy Barnes, was flying. Colin and Tanker 88 got out here first and dropped a load across the head of the fire, right across the head here, crosswind as the winds were blowing this way. And Colin says that load with those winds just quickly dispersed and got rolled up into the flames and smoke and was not very effective. Colin returned to base, reloaded, and returned to the fire and dropped a second load going into the wind along the right flank of the fire, I believe it was, into the wind, and was able to get a nice line of retardant started along this right flank or the east side of the fire. And then Jimmy Barnes was able to jump in here and extend that line just about all the way across to Bennett Street. Then the heavy air tanker, everybody saw the large DC-6, DC-6 Cal Fire contract tanker based out of Chico, I believe, this year. He was in the area. He had a half a load left, and he was able to come in here and drop a nice long load along the left flank, I believe it was, heading the opposite direction, downwind. So four loads of retardant, and they got this thing pretty well boxed in. And then the ground pounders were able to quickly corral this thing. Good work, firefighters. Effective use of aerial retardant, and great work by the ground firefighters. Stop this blaze from becoming something much worse. So back there is the black, or the burned portion, which by the way is one of the safer places to be in the event that you're out here on the front line. You should get caught in one of these situations. In the black, the area that's already burned. Right here I'm standing on the hand line that the forest, that the firefighters cut. Extends all the way down to Bennett Street down there. That's about 4 to 6 feet wide. And right next to that is the retardant line left by the tankers. That's Jimmy Barnes' last drop as he extended it into Bennett Street there. And up here you can see where the hand line and the retardant line worked hand in hand to stop this fire. That's effective use of aerial assets and ground assets combined to stop a small fire from getting bigger. And there's the burned out area in the black along the old railroad line. Retardant's kind of drying up here, but it rains down on the foliage and does just that. It retards the advance of the fire. It just slows the fire down. It allows the ground guys to get in here. It allows them the time to get in here and cut this hand line. So the retardant doesn't necessarily put out the fire. It slows it down. Gives the ground guys some time. It's a mixture of clay and water and fertilizer nowadays. The red, pink retardant, and of course it's colored pink so that the pilots can see where they've dropped and are able to continue to extend the previous line. We're looking south at Bennett Street, and this, by the way, would be considered the right flank of the fire. And down here would be considered the heel of the fire. I'm here in the backyard of DeMartini RV Sales on top of the hill. And here is the left flank of the fire, or the western edge of the fire, and you can see in the trees the retardant line of the big heavy DC-6. He came downwind along this edge of the fire and drew a nice line of retardant, half a load, all along this flank, preventing the fire from going any further west.
God damn, that thing is big, dude.
Piles of the Idaho Maryland mine is where the head of the fire all kind of came to an end. Not a whole lot to burn in these tailing piles here, fortunately, and they were able to get a hold of the fire before it crossed Wolf Creek and Idaho Maryland Road right there. Good thing. Here's the Cal Fire OV-10 Bronco spotter plane. The pilot's in the front and a air attack officer is in the back seat directing the entire air show over the forest fire, orbiting safely up overhead the fire, usually. Sometimes they do some lead plane rolls. Just a handful of pilots are qualified to do that, where they'll go down into the smoke and show the tankers where to drop. Here's the S2T air tanker. The retardant goes in right here, mixture of water, clay, and fertilizer. About 1,000 gallons held in here in the tank. and comes out right here through the doors. They're computer controlled. You can have a short heavy load or a long thin line, and you can control it with the computer controlled doors. Tanker 88 Collins rig, and there's 89 right there. I'm standing here at the end of runway 7 at Nevada County Airport. The Grass Valley Air Attack Base and the tankers are located right up there. The Bennett Street fire was located just a couple miles off the end of the airport runway. In September of 2012, the Grass Valley City Council and my friend Howard Levine, I think, in my opinion, made a very short-sighted decision in disregarding the Caltrans Aeronautical Report regarding safety zones around the airport and the development of Loma Rica Ranch right off the end of this runway. Grass Valley City Council went ahead and approved a plan to build houses right off the end of this runway in direct conflict with what the Caltrans Aeronautical Report indicated and the Airport Land Use Commission wanted to see as far as safety zones go around the airport. These heavily loaded air tankers are just barely clearing the end of the runway here by a matter of feet. And if they have any kind of an engine problem, they're going to be what they call pickling their load or releasing their retardant right here off the end of the runway. Now, the kind of folks that are going to be building the expensive houses that can afford to be built here in Loma Rica Ranch are going to be the kind of influential people that are going to be the first to start complaining about the noise and the hazards of the air tankers operating right off the end of runway 7 here at Nevada County. And Cal Fire is not going to put up with a bunch of heat like that, and they will just as soon gladly move their air tanker operation down to Lincoln, California, where there is no fear of encroachment from housing. And therefore you'll lose that quick response that we saw that kept the Bennett Street fire small.